You are welcome to Bnoskka Productions.
Hello, welcome back again. Yes, this is Bnoskka. I'm telling you, we are looking at artist management, the work of a music manager. And today we are looking at artist grooming. So artist grooming, what is it about? Remember, if you check my video on making a name and brand identity, you find that I talk a little bit about grooming the artist, intellectual branding, branding your mind, okay, branding your character, your financial branding, your costume branding, your logo branding, your trademark, okay, and all that. Now, grooming, basically, we are looking at how to perform, okay, how to get people to move into your song, some stage craft that you need to do. You may look at choreography, you may look at how to engage the audience in your performance so that it becomes lively, okay? And you may want to learn how to dance. If not very good dancing, I mean some basic dance steps that you can use in trailing your audience, okay? So these are the things that you can do. Now, grooming, the basics of all everything is about grooming your artist in communication. A music manager, you must groom your artist. What they should say in public, what they should say in private, their private life and their public life. You must groom your artist. You must let them know that in the public domain, okay, in the public atmosphere, your lifestyle should be in this. You should be like that, okay? And then at your own private home, that is how you should live. But you should always mind you that once you become popular, you become a celebrity, your life in public and your life in private is there's a very thin line, because what you think is your private home, somebody moving, walking somewhere or doing something might see you in your own private life and take a picture of you. So whatever you're doing, even in your private life, you must be very, very concerned about it. So the thin life between your public and your private life is very, very thin. I mean, it's unmeasurable, because you might not know who is videoing you or who is recording your voice. Okay, so that is one, your private and your public life, grooming you how you should communicate. Okay, how you should communicate with people. And then also, you must know that celebrities have attacks. Not attacks in terms of what they call it, in terms of your performance. Somebody wants to drain you down. So be mindful about that. Groom your artist that, look, once your songs are trending, people are going to say a lot of things about you. Things which are not true, okay? Things which are also true, but they will twist it to get to you, okay? So groom your artist that you must know all these things and don't take them personal, because the moment you take them personal, I mean, it can destroy your performances. Because when you get on stage and somebody says something and you take it personal, it's going to push you off. And the day will be messed up just because somebody has said something you don't like. So you must try to look at that also, how to talk to people, how to relate with people, okay, in terms of how and what people will say about you. Now, another aspect also about grooming is about your relationship with both male and female, children and old, okay, the aged and everything. Your relationship. Look, one artist was just making a joke, okay? The next moment it was turned upside down about that joke in a private bar with his friends. And some of them didn't take it that way. And then they made a whole lot of fuss about it. And today the artist is not happy about that. But if you are not able to move on after that, then you have a problem. So I'm letting you know, this is Bnoskka, that you need to groom your artist to get to know that relationships are very, very important. The way people deal with you, the way you relate with people. If you're an artist and wherever people come to you, they are living with bad memory, that's not good. Even if you want to part ways, make sure you do it very professionally. How do I mean by that? You make sure that you tell the person, look, I don't think it's gonna work between us. We can be friends in a long distance, friends, right? But coming close together is not helping us. Okay, so I just want to avoid you, and it's nothing got to do with your performance. It's just that my own personality, that's how I think things should go. And then that should be it. don't render insults, don't be provoked to the extent that you want to exchange blows with somebody. As an artist, you are way beyond that, because whatever action that you portray, people are going to misinterpret it. Somebody would not even hear about it, but would just a little something, a little thing that they hear, they will turn the whole thing upside down. Okay, and you don't know, once you are good, your song is trending, people like you, people follow you, they will say a whole lot about you, things which are true, which are not. So your relationship should be very, very careful. If you are not married, you have to watch who and who you date. Okay, you have to be very, very careful about that, because it's gonna put a weight on your performance. Because psychologically, you might be able to overcome all these challenges to be able to perform. Okay, so moving on, the next thing is about psychology. You have to psych your mind. As a music manager, you have to find words that your artist will reckon with them, that each time you say those words, he knows what you mean. Words that will ginger them, that will push their morale up. Okay, ginger them, give them that vibe to be able to perform. So every time you know that they are damn spirit, don't be questioning them. What is wrong with you? Why don't you know that we have performance and you are behaving like this? Man, you have to be serious. No, as a music manager, you should never speak like that. Never. Try as much as possible to encourage your artist. Sometimes they may receive some calls and they may not want to share that message with you. Don't take it personal. Just give them encouragement. Let them see the business aspect about it, about their performance, their character. Let them see the business aspect about their performance and their talent, okay? That if they're able to control their emotions, it will help them. Okay, so moving on there, we get to temperament. As a music manager, you must know the temperament of your artist. Are they sanguine? Are they melancholic? I mean, all the temperament, the four temperaments, and they are blends, okay? About 12 of them. 12 of them. You may want to consider your artist and find ways and means to deal with them. Okay, don't use harsh words on your artist. Never insult your artist. No, it's unprofessional. If they do something you don't like it, point it out to them politely. I mean, speak to them, because they are matured people. Even if it's a child, encourage them with positive words. Okay, don't run them down and don't be shouting on them. Don't be moving with them in a way that you are touching them in some obscure places. No. You, the music manager, you must groom yourself to be professional. And I run a grooming course for artists and music managers. When you come, if you are interested, you can contact me and I'll give you a very good grooming yourself. I'll groom you as a music manager, the way you should talk with people, the way you should behave in public and in private place and in every part and every day of your life, how you should behave. In that way, because whatever the way you're going to live with your artist is going to also influence them. If they see you as professional, if they see you somebody who is serious with good vibe in them, time management and everything is going to be good. But if you yourself, you don't know time management, you are not good punctual, you are not, your words are not straightforward, you say certain things, you don't mean them, certain things that you should take them seriously, you are playing with them, it's going to be a big blow on your career as a music manager, and it's going to also influence the artist that comes to you to be managed, okay? So be very, very careful about it. Grooming is very important. Okay, grooming is very, very important. Also, you may also want to groom your own self. How do I mean by that? Your way of dealing with challenges in life. Okay, I've spoke about temperament. I've talked about psychologically. Sometimes you may even want to work with a psychologist. But yourself, your human self, the way you think, the way you speak, the way you act, the way you write about people, okay? I have a friend, his name is Officer KOA. He's brought up an initiative called Watch Your Tongue. And if you go to their Watch Your Tongue Initiative Center, they will run you a very good education on character, okay? They'll groom you using the watch your tongue approach. Think right, speak right, act right, and write right. So together with him, we can give you a very good grooming and then groom you. And then also apart from your personal grooming, your haircut, it's about grooming, okay? The way you want to dress, the way you want to wear your clothes, the way you want to let people see you, your pictures that goes out, your image, they must always be on point. It's about grooming, it's your brand, okay? So you must groom your mind that whatever is going out of you, you must approve it. No, I don't like this picture. I'm not talking about other people taking your pictures, but you yourself, your program that you are organizing, okay? Your program outline, your picture that you've taken for the event, you must make sure that it's well up to date, okay? So make sure that you do all these things and it's going to help you. Grooming is very important. Music manager, you need to groom yourself and you need to groom your artist. And then together, your artist can also come for what we call TikTok, okay? TikTok about artist management. It will help clarify issues with your artist, because certain things they might think you are the only person be talking like that. But when they hear it from a third party, it's going to help you. So you groom their mind and you groom yours and make sure that they flow with you, so that in the end, business is what we're looking at, so they can get more programs and get more money. Okay, this is Bnoskka. I'm telling you, it's going to be great. Let us work together and check my other videos. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and it's going to be great, so that you get all notifications of my new videos. Have a wonderful day. This is Bnoskka. I'm telling you. Thank you very much for watching this video. This is Bnoskka Productions coming your way on this artist management series. If you like our video, please make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also share the videos to your artists and to any music manager that you know. If you want a professional course in creativity, intellectual property, and creative art business, please do not hesitate to contact us. Have a wonderful day, and we are so grateful having you always watching our videos.